Hello, everybody. I hope you're all having a great weekend. How are we doing tonight? Tonight, I am going to do a reading for your Cancer child, okay? So, without further ado, let us get a blessing. I've already cleansed my space and we'll get into it. May the sun bring you new energy by day. May the moon softly restore you by night. May the rain wash away your worries. May the breeze blow new strengths into your being. May you walk gently through the world and know its beauty all the days of your life. All right. What do we need to know about the Cancer children? What is it we need to know about your Cancer child? Many cards. What do we need to know about Cancer child? Thank you. Actually, I'm being told to put that one back in, which is kind of weird. I haven't had that happen in a... I got told to put that one back in and reshuffle. I've never had that happen. Cancer children, what would you like us to know? Would you like us to know? Cancer children, please. Cancer children. Okay. Hi, everybody. Okay, so first off, I'm feeling that for some of you, your child might be having a lot of headaches lately. I do want to make you aware that peppermint oil, if you put it on your finger and stick it up in the roof for your mouth, just kind of hold it there. That will help with headaches also, as well, putting a cross here and putting a little dot on each temple. Okay, mom and dad, I am feeling like your little Cancer is very ambitious. Okay, get it, mom and dad. They're kind of a leader. They like to be a little bossy. Nothing wrong with that, you know what I'm saying? I am feeling like your child is feeling, we've had like some outbursts. They're feeling very anxious, okay? Maybe for some of you with older children, you have a little bit of a bigger family. Maybe three kids or more, okay? That's not gonna play for everybody. I'm feeling like they're kind of lacking clarity of your home life. Just clarity of everything in life in general, I'm feeling like, okay, which is okay. I mean, that happens sometimes and it's okay. Kids have to find their way. They kind of have to find who they are and what they're doing, okay? I feel like there might be a little discord in your family room, maybe a lot of fights lately. They are really rebelling. You might feel like this is really hard to deal with. You're kind of wondering why your child is doing that or acting out if they're a little bit younger. I'm feeling like for some of you, you might be having some money problems, some money strains right now. I'm also feeling like for some of you, there is a main male in your life that I do want you to know that you're... I hate being this person. Your child's not too fond of this main male. It's okay, so two stories. Your child is either not fond of the boyfriend that you have, or you and your husband have been fighting a lot about money lately, about, you know, your children acting out or child acting out, and you guys argue a lot in general. And either way, whether you're married or not married, I feel like the people I'm talking to, your child is seeing that this person is not necessarily good for you, that you guys are not a good match for each other. That not only do you guys not make each other very happy because you're argumentative and angry all the time, but this flows over onto the kids, and the kids are really noticing this. And I do need you to understand that for those of you who are married, and this is your child's view of your relationship, and this is, you know, their father, or it's just a man that you've married after. Staying in a relationship because you're married is not always the right thing to do. Staying in a relationship because that's your child's father is not always the right thing to do. And in this case, your child specifically is feeling like it's not. And I do want you to know, as you can see, they're really in their thoughts about this. They are really, really in their thoughts about this, okay? I'm seeing that for a lot of you, you have kids between the ages of 10 and 17, okay? Now, don't get down on yourself because this is a very hard thing, being an adult, being in relationships, but do make sure that you are really paying attention to what you're saying and doing around your kids, because know that they are watching you at all times and they are seeing things at all times. Also, just because they are in another room does not mean they don't hear you. Just because you think that they're asleep does not mean that they're asleep. Even when kids are asleep, just a tip, actually, you can still process and hear things while you are sleeping. So just be very mindful of what you're saying and doing, okay? What does Cancer Child want their parents to know right now? Thank you, thank you. Okay. So at this time, we got freedom. I am feeling like your Cancer Child is really wanting you to free yourself from this situation. I don't think you understand how hard, well, I'm sure you do, but they want you to understand how hard it is for them to see you hurting or the other person hurting and then them be hurting as well. They're looking for a way to free their mind and free themselves from the chaos. And I do want to side note and just stop right there and say I am not down talking anybody's life or parenting situation. I am here to help you and let you know what your child is seeing and thinking and feeling, okay? But they are looking for some sort of freedom from this. You got guilt upside down. So I'm seeing that your child does not. The good thing is they don't feel that they are the problem or the reason that these arguments are going on or that things are the way they are. But I do feel like you feel guilt for this. You are noticing that this is happening. And if you're not, after you see this, you're going to feel a little guilty. Now, mom and dad, I don't want you to feel guilty. I want you to understand that we all make mistakes. But it's not about the mistakes we made. It's about what we do to change those mistakes and make sure that they don't happen anymore, okay? So I'm seeing balance right side up, but I'm seeing this as, and this isn't going to be for everybody, maybe some of you had a toxic childhood, toxic parents, okay? So you feel like this arguing, this toxicity is a normal thing in life, okay? You feel like it's balanced. This is what you saw, this is what you know. And I do want you to know that this is not balance, and your child is realizing that this is not balance. And if they, for those of the children that don't realize that this is not balance, you need to kind of get a hold of this situation and really take a step back and change things, because let's be real, nobody enjoys living in a arguing, toxic relationship all their life. And you staying in those relationships or providing that kind of relationship as an example for your child is going to make them think that that's a balanced relationship, and you are going to continue the cycle, and that is just not a good situation. So I am here to tell you to please break those toxic cycles, thinking that you need to stay with somebody or you need somebody. It's not true. You don't need somebody. You don't have to stay in toxic cycles. Be the one in your family to show your child that it is not normal to have a relationship like that. And if you walk away from that, you are going to be okay. You are going to live, and that you are going to be a lot happier, okay? So surrender. I am feeling like your child is seeing that a lot of the times you fight and fight and fight with this person, and you are the one who kind of gives up and just lets the person have their way, says what you have to say to make them stop or be quiet, okay, is what they're seeing. And they're wanting you to know from their 5D self that they need you to surrender this relationship, not just for yourself, but for them, okay, for all of you guys to be happy, healthy, and spiritually and physically okay, for that matter, okay? Okay, messages from the Cancer children, please. Messages for Cancer children, what would you like us to know, Cancer? Cancer children, what would you like us to know? Cancer children. I'm feeling like a lot of them are kind of really reserved and shut down and not talking a lot. And I do want you to know it is because of all this arguing and fighting. They're feeling very, like, lost and unsure of what to say. They don't want to upset you anymore because they are very empathetic, and they are seeing what you're going through, and they don't want to hurt your feelings or make you upset with them or make you feel any worse than you already do. And that's not a good thing, okay? Okay, do I have any more messages for Cancer children, please? Cancer children, what would you like us to know? Thank you. Okay. So, like I said, I feel like they're having a very hard time communicating to you. I am feeling like... Okay, so we got communication, transition upside down, and root chakra. So, I feel like their root chakra is completely unbalanced. They feel very ungrounded. They feel very sporadic, very chaotic. They keep trying to put their head in the clouds and live in kind of this dream world, or really zone out or not pay attention, okay, because they don't want to hurt and they don't want to see you hurt, most importantly. They're having a hard time communicating this because, like I just told you, they are not wanting to hurt your feelings or make things any harder for you. I see that some of you could be in your 40s. Some of you could... I'm seeing anywhere from 22 to about 46. So, what you need to know is your child, I'm seeing a lot of you have teenagers as well, or preteens, are kind of going through a transition right now. They're changing who they are, what they like, what they're thinking, what they're feeling. Physical and mental and emotional transformation they're going through, and they kind of feel like they're going through it themselves. So please be mindful of that, because they really need you right now. This is a very important time of their life, and the best thing you could do is really be there and show them that these relationships are not healthy and you don't have to stay, okay, mom and dad? I feel like there's been a lot of conflict, a lot of acting out from your child. It's because of this. Because even when you think that they don't hear you or they can't feel your negative emotions, they can. They can hear you. They can feel it. Okay. Messages. Cancer children. What would the Cancer children like to tell us? Messages from Cancer children. I'm going to take that because I'm being told to. Thank you. Uh, Okay. Thank you. Okay. So you got such a curious dream. I feel like your child, like I said, is really trying to stay grounded. They are very hurt right now, but they are not. Here's a card, by the way. They're holographic. I'm so sorry. They're really hurt right now, but they are trying not to do anything to hurt your feelings. Right now, coming home for them is very hard. They kind of try, maybe if they're older, to stay at friends' houses or find other things to do, other people to be around. And it's not because they don't love you or don't want to be around you. It's because they feel like home is so chaotic, okay? You got becoming braver. I see that your child is really trying to be resilient. They are really trying to stay strong for their self. They are a little upset that their home life is this way, but at the same time, they're trying to see from your perspective. They're trying to understand, and I do want to say that it should be the other way around. You should be trying to see from their perspective. You should be trying to understand, because when we try to make them do adult things like that, then what we're doing is we're forcing them to grow up too fast, and you don't want to do that to your child, because it really creates problems for them in the future, okay? You got laws, not justice. So I feel like they feel like this whole situation is extremely unfair, not only to you or your partner, you or your husband, if it's mother and father of the child, but they just feel like it's very unfair to them, very unfair to you. It's unfair to everybody in this situation, and nobody's happy. Everybody's miserable, and they really want to tell you that, and want to tell you that they wish you could see that, okay? So you also got falling. So I feel like they are trying to stay strong right now, and they are trying to be as brave as they can, but they really are kind of losing their grounding, losing their grip. They're kind of falling, you know? They're trying to keep their head above water, and they feel like they are drowning right now. You also got clock time. They feel very pressured. There's a lot of things going on, and they feel like the time that this toxicity has been going on, or this arguing has been going on, has just literally been an eternity, and they really just want the chaos to not only end for them, but for you as well, okay? The song I'm listening to right now is called Damaged, by the way. So they do want you to know that they're feeling very damaged from the situation. You're feeling very helpless. They're feeling very lost. Okay. And like I've said before, and I probably said it in this reading as well, it's not about the mistakes you make. It's about how you correct them, okay? So just know that you're not a horrible person. You can acknowledge the mistakes you've made and do something about it to change it, okay? Whether it be couples counseling, whether it be moving on. But I would definitely make sure that you're being aware of what's going on around your child. I would maybe, I'm not a doctor, but seek therapy for your children, okay? I would also make sure to check in with them, be compassionate, be loving. They really need you right now, okay? Thank you. Cancer children, would they like to say to mom and dad, please? Okay, I'll take those. Thank you. Not too many. Okay. Alright. So I see that some of you could have a boy, multiple boys as well. I'm also seeing that some of you might have boys and girls, or a boy and a girl, okay? negative energy, I do want you to know that they are feeling a lot of negative energy, not only within themselves, but in your house, in your relationship. I don't know if you're spiritual or not. I'm seeing the spiritually gifted card, okay? So your child could be spiritually gifted. You could be spiritually gifted. I do see a lot of negative energy. For those of you who are actually spiritual, I'm seeing a lot of spiritual attacks happening. So cleanse your energy, cleanse your space. Make sure to teach your kids to protect themselves. They are never too young to learn about spirituality, and make sure you're protecting them as well, okay? I see acting out, okay? Your child might be acting out a lot at this time, but, and then I see less work, more play, okay? So part of this might be because not only toxicity in the home or these spiritual attacks, but I'm feeling like for some of you guys, it's because you are more focused on work, yourself, your relationships, or whatever else endeavors you do have in your life. And your child is trying to get your attention to tell you that they need more time with you, okay? Because they are feeling lonely, as you see. They're feeling very lonely. I'm seeing for your kids that go to school, those of you who have those kids, the friends has a sad face, I'm sorry. They're having a hard time expressing themselves as well, apparently. But I'm seeing that some of the friends that they are hanging out with might not be very good friends. I'm seeing that for the other hand of you, your child might be getting picked on a lot at school, might be having a lot of trouble making friends, and is just feeling really lonely and sad right now. I am seeing for a lot of you that there is a grandmother that for some of you, you go and see her a lot, or they spend a lot of time around her, and they do want you to know that they absolutely adore her grandmother. She is a great influence. She makes them happy, and she's a good person to have in their life. For others of you, I see that there is a grandmother that your children adore, and it would help them a lot emotionally and spiritually if they spent more time with this grandmother, okay? I'm seeing for a lot of you, you do not have a dog. You might have other animals. For some of you, you don't have any at all. But I am feeling like a dog, if you can have animals, would really benefit your child with feeling loved and secure and helping them kind of get through the harder times right now. For some of you, you do have a dog, and your child wants you to know that they adore that dog and that they really bond with that dog on a deeper level, okay? And last card you got was love. Your child does want you to know that they absolutely love you. They want what's best for you. They want you to be happy, and they want you all to be extremely close, to have that happy home, to have fulfillment. They watched, for some of you, you cry and struggle and be miserable, and all they want is to see you happy, okay? Because they love you so very much. Okay, let's get some ancestor cards. Okay, can I get a couple ancestor cards for my Cancer parents, please? Okay. Thank you. All right, let's see what we got going on here. So the first card you got out was stag, okay? So I feel like right now, I'm hearing that seeing deer in a headlight. So they feel kind of lost right now, okay? And they're really looking up to you and trusting in you to show them the way, to guide them. And as parents, we love our children. We all want to make sure that we guide them in the right direction and show them healthy boundaries, healthy relationships, and how to live a great life, okay? Because as parents, we want nothing more than for our children to be happy, right? So I am being called to tell you that your child is very confused at this time, that they are really looking to you to know who and how to be in the future, and they really do want to be happy. They want to thrive. So in order for them to do so, They need to watch you do these things, okay? To be in healthy relationships, set healthy boundaries, have good friends, good work ethic, a lot of family bonding, family time, nurturing and loving your children, you know, those type of things. Also, you got Sky Father, okay? For some of you, I feel like you may be in toxic relationships because of the fact that you feel like maybe it is that you can't support yourself. Maybe you have a codependency issue, whether it be financially or emotionally, okay? And I am being called to tell you that you need to trust in the unknown. You need to know that regardless of what the situation is, it's going to work out if you do the right things, okay? For example, if you stay in a toxic relationship because this guy financially, or girl, financially supports you, right? For example, and you think that because they financially support you, you'll have a house and a car and all this stuff and everything's going to work out fine. That's not what's going to happen, okay? Eventually, you'll lose that person, you'll have no stability anyway, and you'll be absolutely miserable. But if you just let go and trust in the divine, and you really go within yourself and start from the bottom, okay, baby steps, and be like, okay, first off, I need to get this. Second off, I need to get this. If you have to move back in with your parents for a while, it is what it is, right? Or if you have to move in with family members, go to a shelter, go get on housing, get food stamps, whatever it is you need to do. Don't be too proud to do that, okay? Because you're being asked to trust in the unknown, and things will fall into place for you a lot better than you think they will, okay? Okay, and then you also got the Air Guardian upside down, okay? So, I don't know why, but I tell people all the time when I pull this card, no matter what reading I do, every time I see her hair, though she has angel wings, I see Medusa, right? It's freaking crazy. I see Medusa snake hair. So, I feel like some of you might be dealing with a very deceptive woman. And I'm seeing the black wings, too. So, it makes me think, like, evil for some reason. Don't ask me why. But I'm feeling that some of you might be in a toxic relationship with a very, like, vindictive baby mama, wife, whatever it may be, okay? And you're being asked to really open your eyes and realize this, because this toxicity is getting you nowhere and doing nothing but filling you with toxicity and hate, filling your children with grief and sorrow, filling you with the same, really hardening your heart to true love and good love, okay? So you are being asked to really open your eyes and see what kind of person you're with. This could also go vice versa. This could be a female dealing with a man who is completely toxic, and you need to open up your eyes and realize that he is a toxic person, not just for you, but for your children, okay? So that is all I have for you today. I hope you all enjoyed my reading. Peace, love, and light. Empress out.